This isn't real.
What is real? How do you define real? If you're talking about what you can feel, what you can smell, what you can taste and see, then real is simply electrical signals interpreted by your brain. This is the world that you know.
We yearn for a universe governed by immutable laws, a reality independent of our fickle perceptions. This objective reality, we believe, exists outside of ourselves, untouched by human bias or interpretation. It forms the bedrock of science, the foundation upon which we've built our understanding of the cosmos. But what if this objectivity, this bedrock of reality, is but a comforting illusion? From the moment we are born, our brains are bombarded with sensory data. We assemble this chaotic symphony of light, sound, and sensation into a coherent picture of the world around us. Yet this picture is necessarily incomplete, a filtered and processed version of reality. Our senses are limited, our experience is subjective. What we perceive as objective truth is in fact filtered through the lens of our individual perception. Consider color. A vibrant red apple signals its ripeness, but the redness itself does not reside in the apple. It arises from the interaction of light waves with the apple's skin and our own visual system. Remove the observer and the redness vanishes. The same logic applies to all our senses: taste, touch, smell. These are not inherent properties of the objects themselves, but rather interpretations made by our brains. If our perception of the world is so subjective, how can we ever hope to achieve true objectivity? The traditional answer lies in consensus. If enough observers agree on something, we deem it objectively true. But this reliance on consensus is fraught with its own set of problems.
Those voting guilty, please raise your hands. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Okay, that's 11 guilty. Those voting not guilty? One, right. 11 guilty, one not guilty. Well, now we know where we are.
Boy, oh boy, there's always one.
History is littered with examples of widely held beliefs that later proved false. The Earth was once considered flat, supported by a consensus of ancient scholars. It took the courage of dissenting voices challenging the status quo to overturn this belief. Consensus, therefore, cannot be the ultimate arbiter of objectivity. It can be swayed by cultural biases, limited by available knowledge, and even manipulated by those in power. Perhaps a more fruitful approach to objectivity lies not in absolute truth, but in reliability and repeatability. If an observation can be independently verified by multiple observers using consistent methods, we can have a degree of confidence in its objectivity. This is the cornerstone of the scientific method: formulate hypotheses, devise testable predictions, and subject those predictions to rigorous experimental scrutiny. In this sense, objectivity becomes an asymptotic concept, much like mathematical ideas of zero and infinity. We can approach it, get closer and closer, through repeated observation and experimentation, but we can never fully grasp it, for it exists outside our subjective experience. This does not render objectivity meaningless. On the contrary, it remains a vital guiding principle. The pursuit of objectivity pushes us to refine our methods, challenge our assumptions, and constantly strive for a more accurate understanding of the universe.
Sonia, what if there is no God?
Boris Dmitrievich, are you joking?
What if we're just a bunch of absurd people who are running around with no rhyme or reason?
But if there is no God, well, then life has no meaning. Why go on living? Why not just commit suicide?
Well, let's not get hysterical. I could be wrong. I'd hate to blow my brains out and then read in the papers they found something.
Boris, let me show you how absurd your position is. All right, let's say that there is no God and each man is free to do exactly as he chooses. Well, what prevents you from murdering somebody?
Well, murder's immoral.
Immorality is subjective.
Yes, but subjectivity is objective.
Not in any rational scheme of perception.
Perception is irrational and implies immanence.
But judgment of any system or a priori relation of phenomena exists in any rational or metaphysical or at least epistemological contradiction to an abstract and empirical concept such as being or to be or to occur in the thing itself or of the thing itself.
Yeah, I've said that many times.
Boris, we must believe in God.
If I could just see a miracle. Just one miracle. If I could see a burning bush or the seas part or my Uncle Sasha pick up a check.
While we may never fully shed the constraints of our subjective perception, the pursuit of objectivity, like the pursuit of knowledge itself, is a journey worth taking.